Hi guys, so Tyler and Tyler here from Austin, Texas. We're hanging out at the Dragon's Lair in North Austin to play a game of Bolt Action. We're members of the Texas Bolt Action League, and this is our first battle report. So let's take a look at what we got. We both ran 1250 points, Americans versus Japanese. Not exactly completely themed because my guys aren't really Marines, but still, you know, pretty close. We kind of have a generic green map here. So maybe like we're fighting in like Burma or something. So anyway, what we've got here in my list, I came with a first lieutenant with submachine gun and rifle. I've got a second lieutenant to lead up the second platoon. He's inexperienced. The first lieutenant's regular. I've got in the first platoon, I've got two vet squads armed with two BARs. One of them has four SMGs. The other one has three SMGs, and then I filled out the rest with rifles. I've got a couple of regular squads here. Actually, I've got one, two, three, four regular squads, mostly just SMG, BAR, and rifles. And then I've got one regular engineer squad that has a flamethrower. And then to support them, I've got a regular medium machine gun, a medium howitzer, a Sherman tank, and I've got an air observer team with the two airstrikes, and they've got a P-40. And so let's see, Tyler, I don't really know what exactly you have, so you talk to me.
1250 list.
Okay.
Brought my armies up in two lists.
Okay.
So let's go with first list.
Okay.
Veteran first lieutenant.
Okay.
Five or seven man squad.
Yep.
One LMG, one SMG. Eight man squad, regular. Veteran medic, regular anti tank rifle. Two inexperienced suicide teams.
Oh,
one
scary.
Howitzer. And one medium heavy howitzer. Open top.
What is that tank called again?
The Ho Row, because it holds a lot of hoes.
The Ho Row. Okay.
The veteran first lieutenant, veteran seven man team, one SMG, one LMG, veteran eight man rifle team, regular seven man team, one SMG, one LMG, one eight man regular infantry team.
Nice.
One regular.
Oh, the cav.
Chiefco. Cavalry.
And they were like Japanese sympathizers.
Japanese sympathizers, yeah.
Yeah, okay, wow.
And then a regular medium anti-tank gun.
Okay, cool. So you're looking at Tyler's beautifully painted Japanese list. Let's go over here to the map. We've got a lot of trenches, a lot of open ground. We've got a trench over here with a bunker. Trenches are going to count as hard cover, and there's going to be a... They also count as a down hit modifier if you're in the trench. We decided that you can actually run into them if you need to, even though they're rough ground. We've got a couple of hills here with some lookout posts. Any kind of like ruins is going to count as hard cover, and any kind of you know, foliage like this or trees, we're going to count as soft cover. And then we've also got three impassable barriers here. These hedgerows of sorts are going to be considered impassable, so it's going to kind of squeeze the infantry in. And then we have some rough ground over here in the middle. And then we've got a house here, two-story house that we are going to you know, put spotters and snipers in. And then over here we have some dead cows that we decided are actually going to give us a plus one, or like a soft cover. So, all right, so we'll go ahead and get the game started, and we will fill you in at the end of each turn. Okay, thanks for watching. Okay, so first turn, the Americans came on. We had the... I put this squad right here. Regular squad came up to the trench. First thing Tyler did was he came on with his, what is that?
Heavy howitzer.
Heavy howitzer. What is that vehicle even called?
Ho-Ro.
The Ho-Ro. And he targeted my forward air observer over here across the field. Forward air observer returned in kind. Put an airstrike on that, which we're going to resolve here in just a second. Then after that, the only thing that really happened is I deployed... my engineer squad over here, regular squads came up along the trench, machine gun, got the second lieutenant there, howitzer came up behind him, And then over on my left flank, I went ahead and grabbed this building over here that's got a pretty good view of the battlefield. I brought on my first lieutenant. My two vet squads came on, as well as one regular squad. That's a vet squad. Those two are, let's see, that vet and regular came on with my Sherman tank, tried to take a shot at the guy that was over in that little dugout over there, missed with everything. But the sniper that's in this building took a shot out that window. Took him out. Over here, behind the dead cows, Tyler deployed his cavalry. A couple of vet squads came on with the medic, and then he brought up the medium anti-tank gun, which I'm sure is going to be taking a shot at that Sherman over there shortly. And he brought on an officer right here. Let's see. Looks like he brought on a light anti-tank rifle. And then still have one more suicide guy hanging out over here in this trench. There's these are regulars right here. These guys right here, also regulars carrying the flag.
Regulars.
And then we've got a bunch of two regular squads. One regular squad over here on the right, one veteran squad, and then a light howitzer.
Correct. Yeah, light howitzer.
Light howitzer, and then looks like we've got an officer kind of bringing up the rear here. So we're going to work out the airstrike, and then we will let you know what happened. All right, so working out the fighter, the air attack on the heavy howitzer Horo. My air attack did indeed come in. It was a ground attack unit. It fired its rockets and definitely penetrated and knocked it out. So happy about that, because that would have been 3D6 howitzer. Those things are like infantry deleters. Okay, cool. Well, we're going to play the second turn, and we'll let you know what happened. Okay, so looking at turn two, and not a lot happened, but a little bit did. So basically what happened was engineers just went down. Airstrike guy got called in a fire order from this light howitzer over here. It missed. So he in turn then called in an airstrike on this regular infantry platoon that just rolled up. We'll be settling that here in just a second. All of my infantry, my regulars, basically moved up into the trench and the machine gun. They all took a couple shots over here at these guys, but they were entrenched really well. So apparently the trench gives you like some kind of, hit modifier, so they didn't take any hits. They fired back over here at the machine gun, same sort of thing, didn't take any hits. The medium howitzer took a shot over at the infantry that was sitting over here. It missed. These guys went on ambush, and it got triggered when Tyler ran his Japanese out here. We managed to get a pin on them and kill one guy, I believe. The vets fared pretty well. They took some shots at the cavalry, killed all but two, took a shot at this squad, which was over here at the time, got them whittled down to two. The tank rolled up. There was a, the tank rolled up. There was a, was it an officer up there on the field that they took out? Or was it a squad? Oh, no, that tank fired at that squad, too. So they basically helped to whittle them down. But then the tank got hit by a medium tank gun. Two medium tank guns, actually. Took three pins. The crew was just stunned. These guys went into ambush. Managed to take a few more shots at these guys. Tyler put his cavalry behind this impassable hedgerow so that the flag is just sticking up there taunting us. And then we've got vets over here in the trees that still haven't really done a lot. They fired over there at my guys, managed to kill, I think, one of the vets. The light AT gun is still cranking. Managed to get those pins on the tank, as well as this light AT gun. Officer rolled up into the little hovel. The sniper took a shot at this medium anti-tank gun, the light anti-tank gun missed. This lone suicide tank man is running across the field. He's got a little ways to go, but he's got fear in his eyes and blood in his eyes. He can see the tank. Ho-ha is still dead. We've got these guys.
It's the ho-ro.
These are regulars, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so the regulars moved into the trench. Oh, the Ho-Ro, that's right, sorry.
The full Ho-Ro.
And then, okay, we've got... these guys have rolled up to the trenches, one regular squad, one veteran squad, just hanging out. Still got the light howitzer here. Officer's waiting in the bush, urging his men on. And we have an airstrike to call in on this infantry squad, so with any luck it won't strafe my own men, and we're going to work that out right now. So it's definitely been a day of U.S. air power. The hit came in again on that squad. It was a ground attack unit again. So they got strafed. They got completely obliterated. The other guys got pins. The officer took some pins. The light howitzer took a few pins, or took one pin. And then the regs took two pins, and the squad over here took pins. And then actually my Americans down here in the trench, they weren't sure what kind of plane it was, and they got a little bit scared, and they actually also took two pins. So now we are going into turn three, and we'll see how that plays out. Okay, so the third turn, a lot of exciting stuff happened. So I guess where we should start is with the, let's start on this side of the map. So over here on the left, the tank rallied. He got his officer, actually he didn't get his officer next to him, but the tank rallied, got all of his pins shaken, got the regs advanced up here, took some shots to eliminate the cavalry, got the vets up here, they advanced, they fired on Tyler's vets. We had one squad that went into ambush, and then when the vets came out of those trees, we managed to get a few more kills. Tyler brought up his medic, and he brought out the vets, and they're just sitting there, just getting ready for the assault. The officer came up, he took a few more shots at the vet. Tyler, at the very end of the game, ran his officer